I had the same question every time I walked this way when I was a kid. Why is this high wall here? And can a wall really block sandstorms? It was only after I grew up that I realized it serves a more important purpose, keeping out people like us.
We've waited a long time for this day to come. Fate has finally dealt me a hand to play against the Academia.
Do you think the resurrection of the Scarlet King can truly change Sumera for the better?
The resurrection of the Scarlet King will only result in war. And war serves no one. A shield is not enough to protect the most important things. That's why I must also wield a spear. Do your worst! Grant us your blessing!
You've betrayed Aru Village.
Don't do anything until I've gotten to the bottom of this. Try something foolish, and even Candace won't be able to protect you.
Through me, justice is served!
If we're unhappy, we should speak up and let our voices be heard. Positions! Huh. Yeah.
Ha! All eyes on me!
Life for the Desert Dwellers has been brutal ever since the Scarlet King's death all those years ago. Feelings of desperation are widespread.
Traitors are what us followers of the Scarlet King despise the most.
One of us could be secretly revealing our whereabouts to the Academia.
Answer me this. If the Sages share any information about their project with you.
We're cheap labor. Livestock, but easier to control. Nothing more.
My experiment is a success. And now it seems they can no longer hold back their sheer adoration.
There is no need to fear. The pain will be brief. Your era is coming to an end.
I am Mika, Surveyor of the Reconnaissance Company. I will now be reading Grandmaster Varka's letter aloud for you all.
Does this mean the Grandmaster knew Razor's parents?
Fill up the barrels and store them away. Then wait for a windier day. Wax the bottles, seal them tight. For the south wind that soothes, for the north wind that bites.
Dear friends, let us now open the wines.
To the Animal Archon!
《原神》即将迎来公测二周年之际，《原神》的 3.1 版本也将如约而至。新版本前夕，
我也再次邀请了原神项目组的同学为大家带来原神 3.1 版本的前瞻特别节目，把游戏内外丰富多彩的内容呈现给每一位旅行者。那么今天来到我们节目现场的第一位研发同学是项目组的场景美术阿汤哥，欢迎欢迎，来给大家打个招呼吧。
旅行者们好，非常开心能够作为场景美术团队的一员，在这里跟大家聊一聊新版本中我们所创作的一些内容。
好的，探索新区域啊，一直是旅途中必不可少的一个主题。那今天啊，就从我们身边的这片沙漠场景开始讲起吧。
好，在提瓦特的世界设定中， 3.1 版本所呈现的新区域是与早已消逝的古代沙漠之神赤王紧密相关的，相信大家也在之前的冒险中听到了这位神明的名字了。
对对，上一个版本的魔神任务里啊，我们的确见识到了一些赤王的狂热信徒，还听到传言说他即将复活。
是啊，有关赤王的传说也在沙漠子民中广泛的流传着，他所创立的曾经异常发达的国度早就已经消亡了，然而古老文明所留下的种种痕迹依然在沙漠中等待着他人来探寻。那么这一次场景美术团队从基础的人文设定出发，在赤王沙漠的设计过程中围绕着古赤王文明所掌握着的神秘知识力量，试着融入一些极具地域特色的元素，将一个更宏伟壮观和具有科技感的世界展现给旅行者们。
我还记得在 3.0 版本的前瞻节目中啊，我们提到过对立主题是虚拟大世界的设计思路之一。
嗯，是的，这种对立主题依然体现在我们的新场景设计里。在 3.1 版本中我们所见到的将是一片以沙漠为核心的神秘区域，在沙漠的风貌创作中我们构想了一些新的设计语言，比如说死亡，它就是一个和雨林所代表的生命相对立的词汇，还有两个新的关键词神秘与科技。基于这些锚点，在这片和雨林截然不同的区域里，我们设计了丰富的自然风景和人文景观供玩家朋友们去体验，比如说埋藏在戈壁峡谷中的机械小堡，富有异域风情的阿如村，在漫天黄沙中甚至还隐藏着一片生机盎然的绿洲，这样的丰饶之地的存在自然而然地让人感觉到好奇和惊讶。当然提到沙漠区域的壮丽景观，更少不了让人震撼的赤王陵，
这个规模真的是很大啊，远远看上去像是正在燃烧的火炬一样。看到这样一座神奇雄伟的陵墓啊，我的探索欲啊已经被拉满了。
怎么去做好沙漠中的美术表现也是花费了我们场景团队不少心思。在预言期间我们甚至去了现实中的一些沙漠地带，实地考察了当地风貌，希望将这种感受在游戏中更好地展现出来，玩家朋友们在赤王沙漠中可以体验到真实细腻的采沙下线，烈日当空的滚滚热浪，壮丽宏伟的赤王遗迹和形态各异的风化奇石，时不时还会有流沙飘过旅行者们的头顶。踩在沙漠中眺望那一望无际的沙丘，听着风声在你耳边划过，这都是之前的区域中所没有的视听体验。
你说了很多走在沙漠上的体验啊，那在黄沙之下是不是也会有更多新鲜的玩法内容？
这是肯定的，在赤王陵区域的关卡设计中，我们大量的运用了箱庭式结构，把赤王遗迹中的重要区域结合玩法布置出来，比如在沙漠特定区域出现的透明遗迹和沙漏玩法，希望能让玩家在古墓遗迹中有更身临其境的感受。而这些在赤王陵附近巡游的自律机关被称为元能构装体，长久以来守卫着这片古老的遗迹，它们是赤王文明所遗留的机械造物，从攻击的方式中也能体现出赤王文明的科技感。而这个群体中的统辖者半永恒统辖矩阵则尤为危险，似乎在其中还残留着陵墓之主的意念，在战斗中它会将元件投射出去，核心进入隐身并且无法受到攻击的不可视状态，旅行者们在探秘过程中要特别小心来自它的威胁。除此之外，沙漠地区还栖息着形态特别的沙漠驼兽以及秃鹫、毒蝎等等沙漠区域特有的生物。
这片沙漠里啊，潜藏着不少的科技造物啊，很微妙，不过很符合我对沙漠的印象，迷人但又很危险。那我猜猜看啊， 3.1 魔神任务的新篇章应该也跟沙漠有不小的关联吧。
没错啊，沙漠是这次主线故事的重要舞台，须弥魔神任务第三幕迷梦与空幻与欺骗，以及第四幕赤土之王与三朝圣者都将在 3.1 版本中更新，旅行者在须弥的故事将会继续推进。
哦，博士和伞兵都要在须弥登场了吗？
看起来是的，两位实力强大的执行官现身须弥，而且还拥有雷神的神之心，我想这一次旅行者们的冒险将会面临着巨大的考验。
这么看来啊，除了掌握须弥的交灵院，我们还要想办法和余恩仲周旋，这要是想破局，大概还是需要利用神明的智慧吧。不知道在沙漠中旅行者会不会有一些新的收获呢？
既然我们前面已经提到了赤王和他的子民，可能玩家朋友们已经开始对接下来的剧情走向有了一些自己的猜想。作为与大慈树王有着重要关联的神明，赤王所留下的文明遗迹中是否会有一些关于须弥历史的蛛丝马迹呢？赤王文明因何而毁灭呢？大慈树王与赤王、雨林与沙漠之间又发生过怎样的故事？我们期待着玩家朋友们来到沙漠探险，寻觅暗藏在沙漠中的秘密。
这趟沙漠之行啊，应该会给我们解开不少谜团。不过要面对这么强大的对手，我们也需要一些可靠的伙伴来并肩作战吧。
那旅行者们不妨考虑一下去一处沙漠子民的聚集地阿如村去看看吧。阿如村是沙漠中最大的聚落，情报和资源都比较丰富，它坐落在山峦之中，是一座坚固的堡垒，也是险恶环境中足以休整的避风港。由于一些特殊的原因，阿如村还收留了不少被教灵院流放至此的学者，相信在那里旅行者们可以探听到更有价值的信息，也可以结识到更多的新朋友。
好的，谢谢阿汤哥给我们带来了不少有关沙漠地区的情报，我非常期待啊制作组给我们带来的这片全新的天地啊，也希望能够早一些在壮阔的沙海当中和大家相见。那稍后我们就一起来了解一下在 3.1 版本中即将和我们相遇的新伙伴吧。
What does freedom really mean when demanded of you by a god?
Hey everybody, it's Yuri Lowenthal. I am so lucky that I get to voice the character of Dainsleif, the mysterious Dainsleif. Dainsleif is the king of tutorials for right now, although he has appeared in the game, and hopefully you've enjoyed traveling with him. I know it's been a blast for me, but he is still full of mystery. Thank you all so much. But this is the second anniversary of Genshin Impact, and I just want to say it's one of the best communities ever.
Greetings, travelers. Keith Silverstein here. You know me, of course, as the voice of Zhongli from Genshin Impact. Now, I gotta say, this game has had such an influence on my life. It's changed everything since I first spoke the words, Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember. It has been an honor and a true privilege to be a part of this beautiful in-game world, and even more so, the ever-expanding community that has grown around it. And it is my absolute pleasure to wish Genshin Impact a happy second anniversary. I can't believe it's been 2 years already. Happy 2 years, Genshin Impact.
Hi, travelers. I'm Laura Post, and I voice the character Yelan. Thank you all so much for being such an incredible, supportive community. I am just blown away by the warm welcome I got when joining the cast, and you've all been just super cool, fun people to interact with, and I'm very grateful for that. Even though Yelan has only been around for a few months, Genshin Impact is celebrating 2 years since its release, so thank you so much to the fans who have been playing from the beginning and to any brand new fans that just started, let's say, a couple months ago with Yelan. Thank you all so much for your continued support.
It's somebody's birthday! What's up, guys? It's Max Metalman, the voice of Arataki Ito, the numero unoist of all the Itos. And I just wanted to say,
Congratulations on 2 years! What an incredible feat! You guys should be so proud of yourselves, and the fans especially should be proud for keeping it going. It's all thanks to you guys that we were able to do this for so long. I am so, so grateful to be part of this game, and not just the game, but this community and this family. And it really feels like a family, not just on the production side, but with the fans as well. And you're always so warm and positive and happy, and you bring so much light to me. I'm so grateful for all of it. And Genshin Impact, I got something to say to you, my dude. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Genshin Impact. Happy birthday to you.
Hello, travelers. This is Erica Mendez, and I am the English voice of Kamisato Ayaka. It's so crazy that it's been 2 years since Genshin Impact came out. I don't even know what to say about the reception so far. It's just been amazing, and I know I can't wait to see what the game has in store for us for later content, and I know you guys probably can't either. So thank you for your continued support and helping the game continue on as it has been.
Peace and good health should be enjoyed by all. If I can provide everyone with a life such as this, I will be content.
Yield! Hear my prayer!
Good deeds and bad. In the end, all will be placed upon the scales.
Guilty! Judgment is upon you.
I'm done warming up. I can do even better now. Here! This dance is for you!
那为了更好地向大家介绍我们的三位新朋友，原神项目组的战斗设计师杨神今天也应邀来到了节目现场。感谢各位旅行者和大伟哥，很高兴在今天的前瞻节目里给大家分享一点关于角色们的趣事。刚才的时机演示，想必已经让大家对星火般有了一个初步的印象。那既然阿汤哥已经提到了阿如村，我们不妨就先从阿如村的守护者混血的赤王后裔坎蒂斯来给大家讲起吧。 好啊，其实，在刚才看演示的时候，我就注意到坎蒂斯啊有一双非常独特的异色瞳。是的，一只是琥珀色，一只是蔚蓝色。那看见这双异色瞳的人，都会对坎蒂斯的身世和来历感到好奇。作为阿如村世代传承的守护者一脉，坎蒂斯他并没有特别高远的志向，他的目标就是保卫好家园，将威胁隔离在阿如村之外。平时呢，坎蒂斯无论是对待村里的人，还是对待外人，都十分的友善。 是一位说话温声细语、散发着温和和治愈光环的成熟女性。
坎蒂斯看上去很温柔啊，居然会有着这么好的身手。这位可靠的守护者在阿如村应该很受欢迎吧？啊，是的。当面对来犯的匪徒或是魔兽，温柔如水的坎蒂斯就会激发出凌厉果敢的气质。该出手时毫不犹豫，他的枪术十分精湛，同时还会使用一面科技感十足的盾牌来辅助战斗。在游戏中， 进行实际操作时，玩家朋友们如果长按坎蒂斯的元素战技，可以形成护盾吸收伤害；而当蓄力完成时，则会进行跳跃攻击，对前方的敌人造成水元素伤害。解锁天赋，流雨交互后，若是在长按元素战技期间受到敌人的攻击，则会立即完成蓄力。释放元素爆发时，坎蒂斯会高举武器，招请神佑，除了造成范围伤害， 还会对队伍中所有的角色赋予赤面珠岛的状态。拥有该状态的角色，在登场时会对周围的敌人发动水波冲击。如果是单手剑、双手剑及长柄武器角色，还会获得水元素附魔。而场上角色的普通攻击对敌人造成元素伤害也将获得提高。作为身手矫健的战士，当坎蒂斯处于队伍中时，自己的角色攀爬时消耗的体力也会降低。
一手持枪，一手持盾，可以说是战士的标准配置了。他战斗的英姿
确实跟外表有着挺鲜明的反差，让人印象深刻。
是的，但其实啊，只要不把争斗带到阿如村，无论是被流放至此的学者，还是歇脚的旅人，坎蒂斯都会拿出甘甜的枣衣和饮料来招待客人们。阿如村和沙漠的子民们也很欢迎各位旅行者的到来啊。
提起枣衣啊，就让我想到了塞诺。我还记得给提娜里的字条上的那个冷笑话。
出生于沙漠的大风机关塞诺，就是我们今天要介绍的第二位新朋友。他看上去是个非常严肃和沉默的人，但却时不时蹦出一些让人完全对不上电波的冷笑话。最可怕的是，当塞诺看到别人完全没有理解他的笑点时，就会一本正经地开始解释其中的笑点，直接让全场的人陷入沉默。
哈哈，我已经有画面了。所以他笑的时候，我们是不是最好跟着笑，别让场面过于尴尬？
对的，大伟哥已经掌握了和塞诺打交道的技巧了。除了冷笑话大师，塞诺还是个打牌高手，酷爱牺牲召唤这款卡牌游戏。如果大家想要邀请他来一局对战，只要不是在工作时间，塞诺是随时随地乐意奉陪的。虽然在生活里，塞诺有着许多与外表不符、有意思的爱好，但是作为教练院维护规则、审判罪恶的大风纪官，塞诺拥有着坚定的个人信念，严格地履行着工作职责，同时又对学者们和知识都保持着谨慎的态度，甚至会刻意地去远离知识。
哦，教练院的大部分人对知识不都是很尊重、很向往的吗？塞诺的行为却背道而驰，这中间有什么原因吗？
作为丽莎的同门，塞诺也见证过不少学者因知识而遭到种种厄运，因此他也很能理解丽莎回到蒙德的选择。而且塞诺也在自己的工作中发现了教练院如今的变化，对于贤者们的行动，他开始了自己的推测和探查。
沙漠出身的塞诺在教练院工作，不知道他对于虚弥的现状又会是什么样的态度和立场呢？
或许这就需要旅行者们去体验新的故事，亲自去问一问他了。作为需要亲自执法的大风纪官，塞诺本身有着不俗的战斗能力。他的元素爆发可以唤醒神灵平一，化身企图试试，将塞诺的普通攻击、重击以下落攻击造成的伤害转化为无法被附魔覆盖的雷元素伤害，同时提高元素精通和抗打断能力，并且还会免疫感电反应造成的伤害。化身期间使用塞诺的元素战技还将释放惊雷的力量，延长化身持续时间。固有天赋落雨的才泽会使塞诺化身时间歇性进入
墨图针眼的状态，
在此状态下释放的元素战技除了伤害会得到提升，还会发射渡荒之雷攻击敌人。对沙漠和雨林都颇为熟悉的塞诺，在须弥执行时长20小时的探索派遣时还会获得额外奖励。
变身后神灵附身的状态很有威压感啊，也难怪那些行为不端的学者会害怕他。
是的，塞诺的气场是非常强大的。那么在给大家稍稍介绍了一下两位新朋友之后，接下来要介绍的这位舞娘妮露想必大家都已经不陌生了。
妮露在花神诞日上的那段舞蹈也是我在 3.0 版本里记忆最深刻的一幕。
在追求知识的学程，妮露的舞蹈可谓是一道独特的风景线。她通过平时的艺术来传达感情，无论观众的身份如何，都能通过她的舞蹈获得治愈。而对妮露自己而言，观众的笑容和喝彩就是对她最好的回馈。
也是一位很接地气、很有个人追求的平民艺术家呢。
其实对于熟悉妮露的须弥居民而言，她更像是穿梭在街头巷尾亲切的邻家小姑娘，热心地帮助周围的人们排忧解难、加油打气。当大家遇到烦心事时，妮露的笑脸与关心就会随之而来。她也热衷于用各种奇奇怪怪的肢体语言来调节情绪，从结果上来看还是挺有效的。
可能看到妮露本身就已经让人感到安心和愉快了，看来妮露和大家关系真的很好。
虽然妮露很擅长治愈他人，不过当负面的情绪落到自己头上时，就会有一些不知所措。如果旅行者们遇到妮露在纠结某件事，不妨也给她出出主意，将她从困境中解救出来吧。
这样一位可爱的少女，她的战斗方式估计会很独特吧？会不会在设计中加入了一些舞步的感觉？
哎，这个想法很合理。妮露的攻击方式非常能体现舞者的特点，普通攻击弦乐舞步是三段非常优雅的剑击，而元素战技七域舞步也做出了两种不同的舞步设计。 释放元素战技后，若是第三段舞步选择了普通攻击，则会施展剑舞步，对触及的敌人造成水元素伤害。此状态下的普通攻击均会转化为剑舞步，并在最后一击时释放水月。如果第三段舞步选择了再次使用元素战技，则会转变为玄舞步，造成水元素范围伤害，并产生一个可以跟随当前场上角色行动的水环，持续为其中的敌人附加潮湿状态。两种舞步各有千秋，旅行者们可以根据战斗环境做出不同的选择。使用元素爆发，妮露会进行远梦灵泉之舞，造成水元素范围伤害，并为命中的敌人附加特殊状态。短暂间隔后，对敌人再次造成水元素伤害。队伍里如果存在至少一位草元素角色和一位水元素角色，且全队均为水或草元素角色时，其余舞步的第三段舞步将会为附近所有角色赋予金杯的崩溃状态。受到草元素攻击后将会提升元素精通，且在触发绽放反应时取代草原核，产生更迅捷更猛烈的丰壤之核。除此之外，妮露在完美烹饪冒险类食物时还有一定概率获得双倍产出。
妮露的战斗方式又美丽又优雅，让人很心动啊。
啊，对了，提醒一下大家，妮露和赛诺的传说任务也将在新版本中开启，不要错过哦。
好了，我们已经认识了这么多新朋友，那其实我也很关心啊，他们什么时候才能进到我自己的队伍中？所以杨神，快来给我们讲讲 3.1 版本的活动起源情报吧。
好的，在 3.1 版本第一阶段，赛诺和温蒂都将迎来概率 up， 同时坎蒂斯也会出现在同期的两个活动起源中，并获得概率提升。版本后半段，除了新朋友妮露的活动起源外，老朋友阿贝多也将迎来复刻。除了角色起源，新版本中还会有一些新的武器加入到武器活动起源中，旅行者们也可以留意一下哦。另外，一些新的怪物也会出现在 3.1 版本中，出现在旅行者的面前。除了前面场景同学提到的半永恒统辖巨阵，遗迹龙兽中的佼佼者赵宰永劫龙兽可能也会给旅行者的冒险带来一定的挑战。作为禁忌技术的产物，它拥有着强大的战斗能力，旅行者们需要找到它的破绽，才能在挑战中更加轻松地应对。
那么接下来老规矩啊，要给大家讲讲我们新版本的活动内容了。不过在此之前呢，各位旅行者就先放松一下，来看一段短片吧。
也请大家持续关注我们接下来的内容，不要走开哦。那接下来就该
Travelers, I'm Erica Harlicker-Stone, the voice of Venti the Bard. Thank you all so much for your support of Genshin over the past 2 years. I can't believe it's been 2 years since it came out. This has been such a special project for me. I absolutely love Venti, and you guys have just made this entire thing so special. So thank you so much for your support. Every time I get to go in to record for Venti, I'm always so excited. I love that we got to do like allergic stuff with him recently. That was super fun. He's just such a fun character, and I can't wait to see what other storylines we're gonna do with him. I'm so excited. And I love that you guys are so excited whenever you see him. It makes me feel so good whenever I see the love that you guys have for Venti. I'm so happy that you love him as much as I do. So congratulations to everyone on 2 years. Yay! I hope there are many more to come. I can't believe how lucky I am to be a part of a project that gives me so much joy and gives so many of you so much joy. So hooray! I hope you continue to love the game. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kimberly Ann Campbell, and I'm the voice of Nahida in Genshin Impact. Thank you, everybody, for all of the love and support you've shown both me and Nahida. I've actually been playing the game on and off since the official launch, so it's an honor to be part of the story. Genshin Impact is celebrating its 2-year anniversary, and I can't wait to see what's in store. I'll be playing right alongside you all.
Congratulations, Genshin Impact. You are celebrating 2 years since your release, and the game just gets more and more fun. Greetings, Genshin Impact Travelers. I'm Lila Berzins, and I voice Xiao. My favorite part about voicing Xiao is that he's both emo, but he's also sensitive, and I think a lot of people can relate to that. One of my favorite moments was meeting a bunch of Genshin cosplayers, and I said Evil Conquering, and they all said Evil Conquering, and then they danced, and it was so much fun. The Genshin Impact fans are incredible, and I just want to say thank you to each and every one of you. You are amazing, and you make my day.
Hey, travelers. My name's Chris Hackney, and I'm the voice of Kamisato Ayato. It's been a crazy ride getting to be a part of Genshin Impact, and I just want to thank everybody for the excitement, especially around Kamisato Ayato. I remember when the Ito trailer first dropped and everybody like heard him for the first time and everyone got so excited. It was really great. And then the reception once Ayato was finally, after being whispered and talked about in the game, finally becoming a real thing. It was really great. I've had an amazing time getting to be a part of Genshin Impact, and I'm really excited to see what the next couple of years brings. So, thanks again, everybody.
Hey guys, I am Susie Young, the voice of the elegant Eula Lawrence. Honestly, the love and passion you guys have for Eula and the game itself is mind-blowing. I just want to thank all the directors and team and you for making this a blast for the past couple years. Thank you so, so much for your support, guys.
Welcome back to the 3.1 version of the special episode. Sitting beside me is our Genshin Project Marketing Director, Michael. Today, he's going to talk about the 3.1 version of the activity content. Thank you, Dawei
Oncle, and the travelers on the screen before the screen. 但我要补充一下，其实除了版本活动，我今天还准备了更多特殊的情报，稍后会跟大家做一下分享。
嗯，你这么一说啊，我这好奇心可就被吊起来了。不过我懂，所谓特殊情报总是要在最后才揭晓的。那么在此之前啊，我们还是先来说说我们的新活动吧。看看今天这现场的气氛啊，是不是蒙德要迎来新的节日了呢？
没错，秋日的蒙德即将要迎来归风加酿节。在民间传说中，这是一个酿造新酒、邀请风神共饮的节日。如果风神对酒感到满意的话呢，就会唤起微风来送上祝福。
的确是很符合蒙德和风神气质的一个节日呢。
值得一提的是，本次的活动故事将会与雷泽有着密切的关系，他的身世也将在剧情中逐步被揭晓。当然，在旅行者热心帮助雷泽的过程中，也会遇到许多蒙德的老朋友，了解更多他们的经历。这个关于亲情与友情的故事，希望大家能够喜欢。
听上去啊，会是一次很温暖也很难忘的体验啊。在这次活动中又会有什么新玩法呢？
活动期间，大家将会陆续解锁秋野防灾技、高峰的演示、义脉与妙想和丰饶的祝愿共四种特色玩法。在秋野防灾技中，大家需要协助猎人来驱逐已经成为不小麻烦的野灵猪，过程中旅行者只能使用普通攻击，同时还可以灵活使用一些道具来提高驱逐的效率，比如可以对野灵猪造成伤害的猎人护盾，以及可同时驱逐一定范围内所有野猪的诱捕装置。而在高峰的演示玩法中，旅行者们将借助特殊的高妙风种子提供的增益效果来挑战强大的敌人，而部分挑战营地中还会存在不同特性的强敌，需要大家谨慎去应对哦。义脉与妙想则是一个以经营店铺为目标的玩法，在开店前啊，大家需要出售酿酒原料和完成客人的委托来筹备足够的资金， 店铺开启后就要通过合理分配可用资金，调整店铺三个方针，来努力获得更高的营业收入。经营过程当中啊，旅行者们还可以通过店铺策略以及邀请助手来协助自己。当然，经营店铺的过程中肯定也少不了一些突发事件嘛，如果能够及时应对的话，还可以获得一些对应的奖励哦。最后一个玩法，丰饶的祝愿中，旅行者们可以根据赠礼留言中的线索，找到布置在各处的丰饶之箱，箱子中储存着蒙德居民的祝福与精心准备的赠礼，等待着大家去开启。这些赠礼中啊，包含一些特殊的装饰品，可以用来装饰义卖与妙想玩法中我们所经营的小店铺。通过体验各种玩法，提高节庆热度，大家还可以获得一把专属四星长柄武器风信之风，以及它的专属精炼道具。
经营玩法还挺新鲜的，在蒙德开店听起来不错啊，而且这次的活动背景还有玩法都很能体现蒙德的特色。
是啊，也希望跟旅行者同行的雷泽可以在旅途中有所收获，有所成长。另一个新活动寻查五峰，这是一个围绕风场展开的需要一定策略的秘境玩法。在这里，旅行者需要合理的利用各种奇异机关产生或关闭风场，改变各种机关的状态，穿破阻碍，抵达一些看上去难以接近的场所。在穿行途中也需要收集一些特殊的风寻币来完成挑战目标，同时在特殊的飓风之境中也会获得一些很有意思的特殊战斗效果。在限定时间内通过收集一定数量的风寻币来达成挑战。此外，旅行者也可以邀请一位队友与自己一起体验一下这个新的秘境。除了挑战玩法与大世界探索相关的活动玩法，寻星之旅也可以帮助大家在紧张的挑战之余稍稍放松一下。装备活动中的特殊小道具可以在各处帮助小女孩巴努寻找未来星的踪迹，距离目标越近，小道具的指向也会越准确，范围也会随之缩小哦。发现未来星的踪迹后，隐藏未来星的谜题将会显现出来，解决谜题找到未来星给巴努，就可以获取原石、摩拉等道具奖励。此外呢，到期的挑战活动百人一魁将会再次开放，更多的战士与魔物将齐聚于会场，等待着大家前去挑战。那么还有一个新的情报要提醒一下各位旅行者们，为了方便大家进行探索啊，在 3.1 版本更新后完成深境螺旋第四层第三间的挑战，就可以直接邀请柯莱进入到自己的队伍中，旅行者们不要忘记前去看看哦。
在新的版本活动之外，我们还做了一些特殊的准备， Michael 也来跟大家透露透露呗。
好的，为了感谢旅行者们一直以来的支持，签到活动全部留侠将会在新版本中开启。旅行者们可以通过累计七日登录获得最多十枚纠缠之源以及其他道具。除此之外，我们还将通过游戏内邮件的形式为旅行者们再次奉上总共1600原石和四枚脆弱树枝，以及两个特殊的纪念小道具，蹦蹦庆典拉炮和飘景机关流云。另外，游戏内商城的首充双倍状态也将会重置，旅行者们可以留意一下官方后续的相关公告。
这样一份小小的礼物啊，也并不能代表我们对旅行者全部的感激之情。玩家朋友对原神的支持和热爱，一直以来都是项目组不断前行的动力。如何在游戏中制作更丰富、更有趣的内容来回馈大家，也是我们长久以来都在思考的问题。
是的，就像大伟哥所说的，优质的游戏内容是我们永恒的追求。接下来就有一个未来版本中新常驻玩法的情报，在这里我也要为大家提前奉上。大家可能已经听过它的名字，极圣召唤。这款风靡提瓦特大陆的卡牌游戏即将在 3.3 版本中与玩家朋友们见面了。
哦，难道说？
没错，可以在原神里面打牌了。在新玩法的模式中，旅行者们既可以邀请不同的角色和 NPC 进行对战，当然也可以和游戏好友进行娱乐对战。这是一个以 PVE 为主的轻度休闲玩法，没有与 PVP 绑定的奖励，而且所有的卡牌啊都可以通过玩法来获取。 在闲暇时光，大家也可以和朋友们来上一局哦。目前机圣召唤还在测试与优化的阶段，不久之后啊，大家就可以亲自去体验了。
3.1 的版本啊，已经有不少活动了，再加上机圣召唤，这次前瞻的活动部分信息量有点大啊。
是啊，那游戏中的新玩法内容，我们就先给大家介绍到这里吧。请各位旅行者稍事休息，更多关于原神宣传内容还有市场活动的消息，我们稍后就来为大家一一揭晓。
Repeat after me. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2.
2. Speaking of 2, it's Genshin Impact's 2nd anniversary! Hey everyone, it's Retina, and I'm the English voice of Yae Miko. Our Gucci of the Grand Narukami Shrine has been with you, in voice at least, since the very beginning of 2.0, and I have honestly just loved seeing all of your reactions to her and to her story and her adventures. I am especially grateful for the warm welcome you gave to me when the game introduced me as her English voice actor. I've loved getting to bring this wily, intelligent, multifaceted Kitsune to life. From the first moment we discovered her signature sound to sharing her story with you in the game. I loved her sense of mischief, I love her playfulness, even when she's being matter-of-fact, and I love that she's a businesswoman, too. I especially have to say thank you to everybody that I got to work with in the booth, our directors, our advisors, the writers, the engineers, and so many other people working behind the scenes who made this process so smooth and so much fun. Voicing Yae Miko has truly been such a joy for me. One of my absolute favorite parts of this journey, really the absolute favorite, has been getting to share it with you, our intrepid travelers. Thank you again so much for your enthusiasm and warmth and love for Yae Miko and for all of the characters who make the world of Genshin Impact what it is. I really can't wait to see what unfolds next.
Hey everyone, my name is Corey Yee and I voice the character Goro. I can't even express the gratitude that I have for the Genshin community and love for my boy Goro. But really, getting to see so many people express their love for the character and his hangout quests has been so meaningful to me as an actor and a player of the game. I've played since launch, and seeing the game and community grow has been a privilege and an honor, and it's one of my absolute favorite projects to work on. Not to mention getting to see Goro get bullied a little bit more in the Iridori Festival, but we don't need to worry about that. What we should be thinking about is that Genshin is celebrating its 2-year anniversary. I can't wait to see more amazing character interactions like what we got to see in the Golden Apple Archipelago. Thank you all for your incredible support.
Hello, I am Albedo, Chief Alchemist of the Knights of Favonius. Just kidding, I'm actually Koi Dao, voice of Albedo, the Chief Alchemist of the Knights of Favonius. Hi, how you doing? Me personally, I've gotten to play a lot of Genshin Impact with my friends. It's been really fun. You can, like, jump off of stuff and climb things. Oh, and you can chase the sealies. Aren't those things cute? They look like they're made out of little gummy fruit snacks. Anyway, Genshin Impact is celebrating 2 years since its release. Can you believe it's been that long? And yet it feels like there's still so many more mysteries yet to unfold, like how many more new lands will we get to explore? How many more new friends will we get to make? What does Paimon actually taste like? Anyway,
Happy 2 years, Genshin Impact!
Hey, what's up, fellow travelers? My name is Zach Aguilar, and I voice Aether in Genshin Impact. Wow, I can't believe it's already been 2 years since the game's release. And I just want to say congrats to the entire Genshin Impact team for their outstanding work. There have been so many amazing events and quests. One of my personal favorites was the We Will Be Reunited quest, when the traveler comes face to face with their sibling again. Working on the game has brought me so many new friends and incredible memories. Honestly, I just feel really blessed to be a part of this awesome community. Thanks for letting me be your Aether, and I'm excited to continue this amazing journey together.
Hi everyone, I'm Sarah Miller-Cruz, and I'm the voice of Lumine. Thank you for all of your love and support for Lumine. I just feel so grateful that I get to be part of bringing her to life. Genshin Impact is celebrating 2 years since its release, which seems kind of bonkers to me because it feels like no time has passed at all, but it actually has been 2 years. That means it's been 2 whole years of journeying through Teyvat with Lumine and her emergency food. I mean, Paimon. Thank you for traveling with us all across Teyvat, and hopefully we'll have lots more adventures to come.
Happy 2 years, Genshin Impact!
自从踏上提瓦特大陆，原神的游戏音乐就始终伴随着各位旅行者，随着我们的足迹不断深入须弥啊，相信大家对须弥地区的音乐也已经不再陌生了。3.1 版本期间，我们将发布第一张须弥地区的原神音乐专辑《至妙明论之灵》，旅行者们将收听到由 Hoya Mix 音乐团队为须弥地区创作的独具区域特色的音乐，除了经典的须弥主题曲、战斗曲外，专辑内也包含了须弥地图中各个经典的人文景观的 BGM。
没错，在专辑发布期间，我们也将为大家带来须弥相关音乐制作的幕后花絮。那么接下来就请旅行者们先观赏一段来自须弥地区人文音乐的 MV 吧。
哎，今天 Michael 好像是有什么新的内容或者消息要带给大家吗？
是的，在过去几个版本里，我们一直在做一些新内容的探索跟尝试，像 2.5 版本剧情 CM 短片、 2.6 版本雪霁逢春，以及前段时间被大家热烈讨论的冬夜鱼戏等。旅行者们的反响跟支持啊，都远远地超出了我们的预期。在这里非常感谢大家，我们会继续努力，为大家献上更多更好的内容。
我发现啊，旅行者们也经常会在这些作品下面留言，希望我们努把力提供更多丰富的原神内容呢。
在此啊，为了回报旅行者们一直以来的支持，我们特意策划了一个新的项目。话不多说，就请大家欣赏这段 PV 吧。
哇，等了这么久，我们原神也终于迎来了自己的长篇动画了。
是啊，经过一系列的努力，今天我们很高兴的在周年庆为大家送上这份惊喜，正式公布原神和 Youth Table 合作的动画项目。我们也将保持对于原神游戏优质内容的一贯坚持，紧锣密鼓的投入项目的制作，争取动画项目能够尽早的跟旅行者们见面，也期待后续大家能够喜欢和支持这部作品。
I've brought that thing you asked me for. The report on my run-in with your with a certain traveler.
Good. As for this traveler, please append my following words to the report.
My pen is at the ready.
After the traveler awoke in the land of Teyvat, he befriended a companion who declared themselves to be the best tour guide ever.
Ah, this sounds like the intro to an isekai light novel from Inazuma. But I doubt that tiny and scatterbrained partner is going to be of much help. If you want my opinion, she's got nothing on your former partner.
He encountered a mysterious tempest and rescued a mighty dragon that had been led astray. Gentle winds once again danced across the earth as a wandering bard sang a ballad of freedom.
Ah, looks like these bishops are a completely different breed from those down beneath the ocean. Actually, speaking of the sea, Mondstadt's fisherman's toast, always on point.
He saw resolve as unyielding as rock, and the courage of a people united in battle against an ancient god. Now the sound of laughter rings out in the streets, and the floating pavilion in the sky will bear witness to the harbor's prosperity for generations to come.
To be fair, if I was napping on the beach and something got between me and my son, I'd go from catching rays to making waves pretty quickly too. Is that not how it went down?
He heard the whispered aspirations of a nation's people, and so challenged the embodiment of resplendent lightning. When a dream takes root in the midst of the infinite turbulence, even eternity is given a new meaning.
He picked a fight with an Archon? This guy's a beast! Well, now I don't feel so bad about those beatings I took.
He caught the scent of verdure and the fragrance of roses. And then...
Your Highness?
Let's continue another time. Sooner or later, he will make his mark on the desert.
You're not wrong, but, marks don't last very long on the desert sand.
I wonder what choices you will make, Ether.
Shall I come with you, or... guessing that's a no.
In the new version, whether it's in the game or in the game, there are many fun and fun activities waiting for
you. And here, I also thank you for all of our supporters. I hope you can experience more in the new adventure, and more surprises and
joy. Okay.那么在今天的节目即将结束之前啊，我想代表原神项目组再次向所有的玩家朋友表示感谢。在你们的热爱与支持下，我们一起在提瓦特大陆又度过了充实而精彩的一年。我也由衷的希望原神可以一直陪伴着旅行者，游历更广阔的世界，见证更多美好与奇迹。9月28日，301版本，我们不见不散。